We'll see the time complexity of this infix to postfix conversion. Okay, so first of all we try to understand the algorithm's idea. What it was doing, there is a for loop, right? For every symbol, we are doing this. So for every symbol what we do is we have a while loop, correct? Before that, if symbol is something, if symbol is operand, then it's very easy, simply print it, correct or not? So print. But the difficult part is if symbol is operator, else, correct? Then we have a while loop, correct? In the while loop, we compare the precedences, right? So precedence of, you know, top of the stack, and we compare it with what? Greater than precedence of, you know, current symbol. Based on that, we wrote the loop, right? In the loop, there is only one line or two lines after all, correct? But what is my question is, what is the time complexity of this while loop? Okay, for one symbol we think about it. So in while loop, what are you doing? We are simply, you know, popping the elements, correct? In the worst case, what can happen is, example, you have symbol like star, after that, you know, power, after that one more power, one more power. In that way, if there are already n minus one symbols, let's say, okay, so here what is my assumption is my input length is n. Sir, if you have n symbols, how can you have, you know, n minus 1 symbols in the stack? That is actually not possible, right? So strictly speaking, how to say this one is, so whenever you have a infix expression on that, almost, example, let's try 2 plus 3 star 4. What I want to say is exactly, otherwise, you know, almost half of the things are operators. Half of the things are operands. You check it out. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Out of 9, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 operators and 5 operands. Always the relation will be, you know, there will be one more operand than operators. Okay. So if you see asymptotically, almost we have half operands, half operators. If we think in that way, then approximately we have only n by 2 operators in the complete list. Okay. What can happen sometimes, I'm talking about, you know, one possibility. In one possibility, when you are scanning the last symbol, maybe all these operators which are remaining, which are how many? N by 2 minus 1. All these operators, let's say star, power, power, assume that all are power operators, something. If all these n by 2 minus 1 operators are on the stack, then now you are processing the last symbol. Okay, then what can happen? This while loop. And this while loop is always, let's say in this one, always condition is true, then we will be popping all the elements of the stack, correct? Then how many elements you are popping? N by 2 minus 1 approximately, correct? Then some people, you know, calculate this thing wrongly. What they think is, sir, to process one symbol, in the worst case, we are taking N by 2 minus 1 pops, correct? Each pop takes 1 unit of time. Then to do n by 2 minus 1 pops, it takes n by 2 minus 1 units, correct? What, sir, if every symbol, whenever I process an operator, if same thing happens, of course it won't happen, but people, you know, say that in the worst case, they assume like that. In the worst case, let's say if it happens, not exactly n by 2 minus 1, maybe in this order that happens, let's say, maybe, you know, less than that, but almost n by 2 minus 1 units it happens, then what happens? For first operator, how many operators we have? Approximately n by 2, right? For every operator, let's say if this much time happens, then n by 2 minus 1 plus n by 2 minus 1 plus so on. If it happens, then how many times we have to do that? N by 2 times, because there are n by 2 operators. So n by 2 minus 1, n by 2 minus 1. Here I use some simple, you know, approximation. I remove n by 2 minus 1, then I can say n by 2. So n by 2 minus 1 almost equal to n by 2. In that way, if I approximate it, then n by 2, how many times? N by 2 times. That will become what? N square by 4. And they say asymptotically it is n square. And people say that the time complexity of converting from infix to postfix is order of n square, they say. But it is wrong. The reason, this while loop is not executed for, you know, every time n by 2 minus 1. Why? If you execute such thing one time, all the symbols will be popped from the stack. Then second time you can't go into that length, correct? That means you can't do that many computations. That's why. So rather than doing, calculation with these loops and all, we do in a different way. That is called amortized analysis. What is that? Is simple. So rather than solving this problem like this, I will tell you one more method. You try to use that method. You going to use this method so many times. That's why try to understand it. So how I calculate the time complexity of this algorithm is like this. First, I observe what are the things you are doing in this algorithm. Okay, don't go with the code, just go back to idea. What was the idea? Our idea was, when you have a stack, every time, so based on your symbol, if the symbol is operand, you simply print it. If symbol is operator, so either you pushed it, otherwise, what you did, you popped some elements and again you pushed something, correct? What I want to say is, in your entire algorithm, so based on the symbol, after comparing the priority, you see, for every comparison, you are either pushing an element, otherwise popping an element, correct or not? Okay, in your algorithm, there are some push operations, there are some pop operations, and there are some comparisons. Okay, let's try to understand, where are you pushing, where are you popping, and where are you comparing? See the code. In this code, you are checking whether symbol is operand or operator, first of all. We'll come to that part. What is the time complexity of checking every symbol, whether it is operand or operator? It's a constant time, correct? Let me list out. First thing, in my algorithm, I am doing some activities. Activity number one, I am checking my symbol is, what is that symbol? Symbol type, correct? How much time it will take? It will take, because every symbol we have to check, then it takes n units of time, because there are n symbols. Second thing, now after that, what you do, if the symbol is operand, you push it, correct? You print it. If the symbol is not operand, then you do, based on the precedences, you either push or pop. What I want to say is, in your algorithm, there are some push operations, okay? Then there are some pop operations, correct? Do we have anything else other than this? Yes. This, see the loop. In this loop, we are comparing the precedences, correct? Then comparison of the, I can say comparison of precedences, correct? Now we'll see, you are not doing more than this. You are simply checking whether symbol is operand or operator, that one thing. Second one, you are comparing, precedences of top of the stack, and second one is what? Current symbol always. How many times you did, I will tell you, but you did it. Comparisons, I can say. And after that, there are some push operations, there are some pop operations. Other than that, you are not doing anything. Isn't it? And maybe one more extra thing you are doing, maybe you are printing, correct? You are printing in the output. How many times you do printing? Because for every symbol, one time, correct? Let's say we do this one also. Let's focus on everything. First, symbol type takes n units of time, correct? Because there are n symbols. Now, comparison of precedences. I will come back to comparison of precedences. Before that, let me see push operations. How many push operations you are doing in this algorithm? Just recall the algorithm. We'll ask operators. Mr. Operator, are you pushed always? Yes, every operator is pushed, correct? Then if you ask this operator, it says, yes, I have been pushed into the stack, it says, correct? Now, how many times you ask? Then that star says, I have been pushed only once, correct? We are not at all pushing any operator twice. Once we are pushing it, after that, eventually, slowly, we are popping it. Then this operator says, that's why I go per operator. That means for each operator, I will calculate number of push and number of pop. Okay. Then each operator says that I have been pushed once and I have been popped once. Then there are two operations. Each one takes constant time, correct? Push takes constant time, pop takes constant time. But I am calculating number of push operations. The number of push operations are only n, at most n, I can say, correct? So why at most n? Because every symbol is not operator. There are some operands. That's why approximately n by 2 operands are there. Everything is pushed, then n by 2 push operations. Let me calculate the time complexity also. Each push takes dash time, constant time, order of 1. Then how many such n operations? N by 2. Then n by 2 into constant, correct? Then it will be n by 2 approximately. That constant doesn't matter for us, correct? Then number of pop operations. Every element is only popped once. If you observe the algorithm, you realize it. Then how many pop operations are there? approximately n by 2. That's why n by 2 into each pop operation takes constant time. Then I have calculated the time for number of pop operations, correct? So what is there in an algorithm? This step, printing. How many times you are printing? Every symbol only once. Then each printing, that is my assumption. So you are in C programming, I don't know, I have not implemented printing, correct? So there is a printf function. So we usually assume that printf takes 1 unit of time, okay? If that is just assumption, we don't know. But so always we assume that, let's say printf takes 1 unit of time, otherwise we cannot go forward, okay? That's why. How many such printfs? N by 2, all the symbols, right? Then n. Now the only thing remaining, comparison of precedences. Sir, how many times this comparison happens? Very simple. When you do that comparison, after that immediately we will come into the loop, correct? Almost. Then we are doing a pop. So if number of pop operations are only n by 2, then you can't do more than n by 2 comparisons, because every comparison, either it is popping, if condition is false, it's pushing, correct or not? Then I want to say that number of times this comparison is executed equal to number of pop operations plus number of push operations. Why? If comparison becomes true, then we do popping. If comparison becomes false, then you are pushing. Either pushing or popping is definitely done after every comparison. This is very important remark. What is that? After comparison of dash, this precedences of that symbols, after comparison, I can say, what are you doing? Definitely you are going for pop, otherwise you are going to push. Then number of push operations and number of pop operations all together are only n. Then you can't have more than n comparisons, try to understand, correct? So it's like this example. Let's say, you know, after example, there is a shop, okay? In that there is a person, okay? Now there is a shop and that he is a, you know, he's manager. There are some laddus, okay? Now there are some chocolates. Now every time you have to eat laddu or chocolate, you have to go through this counter. In that counter, you have to give some money, 1 rupee coin or something, and either you have to take laddu, otherwise chocolate, okay? Then laddus are like push operations, chocolates are pop operations. Putting coin here is nothing but comparison. Without comparison, we are not doing push and pop. Then number of times you put this, you know, you go to this manager and give money is definitely can be calculated using number of, you know, I mean, number of times you ate laddus and number of times you eat chocolates, correct? Example, you ate 100 laddus and 50 chocolates. Then number of times you gave money to him cannot be more than 150, correct or not? In the same way, so if the number of push operations are n by 2, number of pop operations are n by 2, then you can't have complexity more than this for comparison of precedences. That's why number of comparisons are at most n by 2 plus n by 2, not more than this. Then only n. And each comparison takes dash time, definitely 1 unit of time, isn't it? Already that is our assumption. In our programming, generally, to compare two elements' priorities, it takes only constant time. So there are n comparisons, each comparison takes only 1 unit of time. Finally, let me list it out. So if I list it out, then symbol type, to do this one, n units, and comparison of precedences, n units, push operations are taking n by 2, pop operations are taking n by 2, and printing is taking n. Then if you sum up all, so don't do that. So easily I can say that, sir, maybe some 6n or 7n or 100n, doesn't matter. So it is constant into n. Whenever an algorithm's time complexity is constant into n, then we say that c into n, let's say this is your time complexity, let's say f of n, okay? Question number one, is this f of n is order of n? Absolutely, because any c into n is order of n. Second one, is your program time complexity Cn is theta of n? Absolutely. Is it omega of n? Absolutely. You remember one thing, Cn is order of n, Cn is theta of n, Cn is omega of n. That's why we can say that this algorithm's time complexity either order of n or omega of n or theta of n, all are correct, okay?